Video Fashion Monthly brings a brand new kind of fashion magazine to life. It's your front row seat to the glamour and excitement of style-making events around the world. It's your ticket to meet the trendsetters and the fashion legends. Find out what's new and what's next. See what's hot and how to get it. In this issue, Video Fashion Monthly takes you to Milan to meet the creators of Italian style. What makes the Italian designers so unique?
I believe that the creativity of Italian is the first reason.
And in the fashion news, Prince. See why. How did our video cover girl become the newest darling of the Italian runways?
One photographer asked me if I want a picture. And yeah, sure.
Meet Lara Biagiotti, one of Italy's top designers, and find out her secret to success. Plus, an interview with Elio Fiorucci, the man behind that famous Fiorucci name. And Karl Lagerfeld for Fendi. It's a family affair.
It's very easy in Italy to work with big family groups because nothing is stronger than a big family group. So it's very, very pleasant, you know.
See how Revlon creates a beautiful makeover for spring. Then find out why shorts are the leg-revealing must-buy. Milan, a city of contrasts where art and architecture and an eye for the beautiful have given Italy a reputation for classic style. In fashion, the Italian designers have continued the tradition by creating clothing with impeccable style. What makes the Italian designers so unique?
What makes the Milanese unique? Well, I think there is a big research in qualities, in styles, and also in the request and in the demand of the customers. And all those things together makes Milano special.
I believe that the creativity of Italian is the first reason, because I think always Italians are creative and inventing. And
for the Italians, it's obvious because they've had a long tradition of making beautiful images, obviously, in painting and sculpture, in architecture.
These were really nice clothes that were expensive, luxurious, and not bizarre. And what more can fashion offer, really?
Around the world, Italian design continues to influence fashion and style with rich tradition and business savvy that spells elegance and innovation in fashion today. Giorgio Armani is one of Milan's fashion greats, the indisputed master of classic Italian design. He presents his collections with an eye for beautiful images in theater. But it's not the theatrics that steal his shows, it's his decade-long career of creating fine clothes that work for today's woman.
E anche senza voler fare del femminismo, trovo che le donne hanno trovato un posto loro accanto all'uomo in maniera decisa. Fanno dello sport senza problemi, cioè è un modo diverso di vivere da parte della donna, chiaramente. Una volta la donna era una bambolina, era messa lì per un certo scopo.
Giorgio Armani's style has given him a reputation for classic, well-cut clothing. He began his career as a menswear designer, but had no real formal training as a tailor. Quickly he learned the art of precision, and his eye for proportion tailors women's wear with femininity and subtle elegance. Unmistakably, Armani's genius is in adapting, translating, and tailoring the scale of his menswear for women. He mixes and combines textures in extraordinary combinations using the essential luxurious fabrics. Today, Armani designs 29 collections a year for both men and women, accounting for a $220 million business. Who is the woman Armani designs for?
È quella che riesce a superare tutte le imposizioni, che riesce a superare anche quello che di solito si dice è chic, di solito si dice è bello per tutti. Quello che riesce a dimenticare certe regole fisse e trova in un pullover comprato a un mercato, piuttosto che in un foulard messo in una certa maniera, il suo proprio chic.
In the evening, Giorgio Armani keeps the same simplicity of shape and precision of line, but with dazzling differences. His attention to evening wear translates his basic shapes into luxurious fabrics. Sheer chiffons, satins, and glimmering sequins. His sequined evening shorts were showstoppers, a daring fashion statement for glamorous, sexy evenings. Giorgio Armani, the undisputed master of Italian design. Meet our video cover girl, Francesca, a young Roman beauty whose classic Italian looks are bringing her worldwide success. How did Francesca start modeling?
It's very funny because I stay in the discotheque one dance. I speak a little. One photographer asked me if I want a picture. Mm-hmm. And yes, sure.
That picture led to many more for Francesca, and Italy's own Giorgio Armani helped to launch her career, which now takes her to the top runways of the world. We asked Francesca about these fashion shows.
Maybe I prefer fashion show.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Why is that?
I don't know why, but because I movie and smile, the contact with the people, it's better.
Yes.
Prima, before, my father not very happy. After, when him look in the television or in the picture, very soddisfatto, come si dice?
Was satisfied.
Satisfied.
We met up with Francesca again, working for the New York designers. How was that first experience in New York?
First time, I'm very nervous. I'm very nervous because I don't know nothing. Mm-hmm. And after, when I'm outside for the first time, I relax.
Francesca was a success in New York, and the designers say it best.
What attracted us about Francesca was her sense of spirit and, you know, just the attitude with which she shows clothes.
I was looking for new faces, and it happened to be she was one of my favorite girls. That's the reason I took her. And she worked out very well, I think.
She's beautiful, she's wonderful looking. This is the first time I have used her, and she looks sort of like a Roman coin, you know. She has a wonderful face. Mm-hmm. Very, very beautiful. Mm-hmm.
She communicates with just, you know, she has a sense of clothing, and she can put something on and you really don't have to say anything about it. She sort of does feel, you know, this is what I should do. And she manages to project it. It's amazing how really the really great models have that.
Francesca, the Italian beauty who has what it takes.
The look for the spring is called Tropics, and the colors will be, I mean, I have already applied foundation. As you see, it's very clear, very light. The colors of the foundation are light and almost porcelain-like. The colors are those, you see? The lavender in that shade, the aqua, slightly more into the deeper mauve and pink, And the pale grays, which I will blend into. I'm using a color which is called hued blue green.
And you're applying it there.
And applying it on the on her eyelid, going almost to the crease of her eyelid. In other words, filling it out completely, and then afterwards shading it in with the mauve. This is the mauve that I'm trying to shade her with to pick up the color of what she's wearing. See, I'm drawing like a U here almost. You see a point coming out here, bringing it over to that side of the eye and giving it a depth here. I normally like to outline the lips with a lip liner pencil because it gives me a better shape. It's a good thing to use because, first of all, you can shape your lips. Second, when you're a little bit older and you have a tendency of creases and lipstick bleeding, pencil stops the bleeding. I'm trying to fill out her lips with a color. It's just frosted and highly luminous so that it'll pick up the light. To keep the blusher on better, I use a glimmer or a cream. Blusher underneath the blusher that I shall apply. So it fixes, it keeps it again from flying off. I mean, when you work, when you perspire, when you walk. You can do tremendously things with blush on. You can round out a face, you can frame a face. But I think the most important thing is to know one's face and to try and adapt the look to the face and not the face to the look.
Hot Tropics by Revlon, a great new look for spring. Italy is home for some of fashion's most successful women designers. Season after season, their collections influence fashion for the modern woman. Meet Lara Biagiotti, one of Italy's leading design talents who has consistently given her clothes a sense of femininity and simplicity. Her success comes from an intelligent, thoughtful approach to the business of fashion. The Lara Biagiotti name is known throughout the world in fashion, cosmetics, perfume, and accessories. How did she become a fashion leader?
I loved fashion because my mother was involved in that job since I was very young, so I knew about fashion. We went some time in Paris. But, you know, I received from my family always a great freedom. I can select what I want. So I selected fashion myself because I think that is very feminine, job very creative. And when I was very young, I believed to be an archaeologist in my life. I studied that at the university, so maybe that is the reason I am so fine to recuperate even old materials and transfer it in the fashion of today. This passion bring me to restore this old place where I live in Rome, the old castle. We spent 4 years in working. So when I found this place, I fell in love with the beauties of the architecture, but it was like a ruin, like the Colosseum, no windows, no doors, the roof was really falling down. And so I tried to put back the life in this place, and with my fashion, step by step, we are living there, we are working there. I'm very happy that such a beautiful place is not totally destroyed. So, of that spirit, I keep in fashion the idea to research continuously something new that comes in some case even from the past, I think. You know, you look on the back to find a way to go on in the future. Especially this season, I have a specific inspiration from a book I found in London in the spring. It was The Last Mirage. So I start to think about India and what India mean in fashion and British elegance of India the last century.
I start with that long shirt, very straight, to use with pants. And I love also, again, a lot of skirt. I put in my collection a lot of skirt and round shoulder. In my opinion, the shoulder are coming more feminine, more soft. I love red and fuchsia, and I call bougainville the fuchsia this year because it's the Indian flower. And I put a new deep orange red that I like very much, and white, but all the shades of white. So I love the ivory, I love the oatmeal, I love all the shade, the snow, many different whites.
I think that fashion in this moment needs a little more care than before. Now, the women just don't want to buy a simple dress. I think they want even a little dream inside of the dress.
People recognize my dress because they have a lot of love inside.
This dedicated love for fashion is her key to success. Lara Biagiotti, a leader in Italian style. Fiorucci, that name has become associated with youth and innovative design around the world. Come with us to the Fiorucci boutique in Milan and meet the man behind this trendsetting establishment.
Venivamo da un periodo dove la moda era imposta e andavamo verso un periodo dove la moda doveva essere libera espressione della gente. Questo è importante. Ho cominciato, direi, con le scarpe, con le shoes. Però era un amore che coinvolgeva lo stile di vita dei giovani, per cui non era un articolo.
Fiorucci's love for that young lifestyle is brilliantly marketed worldwide. What is the attitude they sell?
For me, the attitude that Fiorucci has is the same as mine in fashion, that should be fun, that it should not be taken over seriously, and that people should enjoy dressing up. My role is merely to put it into print, and then we follow the whole thing through. To make something which we hope is understandable but also attractive to look at. No, I think that with Fiorucci, they're non-seasonal, so that the main thing is to get the mood of an attitude of Fiorucci over, more than saying this is right for this season. You can cross over so much from one season to another. And so that with Fiorucci's catalog, we try and express it. The attitude. That attitude is that you mix the pieces together and enjoy the dressing up.
Dressing up at Fiorucci is an adventure in creativity and innovation from Italian genius Elio Fiorucci. Fendi is one of the oldest design families in Italy, where the five Fendi sisters work with the genius of German-born Karl Lagerfeld to create sophisticated, classic clothes. What does the Fendi name stand for under the design focus of Karl Lagerfeld?
I worked with them for such a long time, nearly 18 or 20 years, so for me, it's even difficult to describe because it seems all normal. No? It's very easy, they're very well organized, they have a lot of people working for them, but they do a lot of work themselves. And when I come for the fittings, they are all there, all the five sisters, everybody's interested, everybody takes care of one division. So it's very easy in Italy to work with big family groups because nothing is stronger than a big family group. So I try to do it my way, but my Italian way. You know, it's another country, another sensibility. I use also, in a way, their personality, the atmosphere of the house, the family feeling and all that, and the whole thing is put together in a collection, you see. Yeah? So it's me, it's them, it's my Italian version. So it's different because it's done in a different atmosphere with different people, so it cannot be the same. And the prints I designed by just cutting out pieces of paper and then I glued them together. It just came, you know. You never must ask yourself so many questions. Now there was no print, now I do print. Suddenly you feel print again, and then you print again. It's as simple as that, you know. I work with my instinct. This is not a marketing operation. Color never shows so well then against a background of dark colors. Huh? But I like the bright fuchsia pink and the pale blue, and that also was used plain to make an opposition to the print, you know, to make the print come out.
Lagerfeld's prints for Fendi made fashion headlines with their unique appeal to the women of the 80s. We talked to one of the Fendi sisters about the Fendi customer.
La nostra collezione e il nostro grif prende tutte le donne, nel senso dalla giovanissima alla sessantenne può venire da Fendi.
From classic day wear with simple clean lines to elegant evening wear, Fendi offers women a range of beautiful classics. How does Karl translate that philosophy of something for every woman into the Fendi line?
Suddenly you feel it that way and you do it. Huh? There is no reason why. the simple explanation is the fact that it exists. I think it's, fashion is simpler than people think. Huh? You mustn't analyze it too much. Things have to happen the way they happen. Huh?
Fendi, creative fashion design that's a family tradition. In Milan and around the world, prints have returned, making big news in fashion.
Print is a big message.
I think prints are a very important part of the news.
It's probably a reaction, a continuation of a reaction against all that monochromatic dressing.
There was such a long time with no print that I thought there was a need, a real need for a kind of print revival. Huh?
And the prints are very dynamic.
Dynamic prints exploded with color on the runways in Milan, Paris, in London and New York. But what's the biggest story in prints this season?
And this is the season for the very bright, large, or very romantic pale flowers.
English country garden gone berserk.
South of France, it was that sort of country feeling.
That country feeling was captured around the world. Florals were strewn everywhere. In New York, Ralph Lauren's florals are reminiscent of old country furnishings. Keith Vardy mixed his florals with checks for Biblos. And even in London, florals bloomed on a sundress from Wendy Dagworthy. Oscar De La Renta even splashed evening gowns with sprays of flowers, but everything's coming up roses.
I was looking in the Sanderson, you know, the old Sanderson prints, big roses and things, and then suddenly, oh, we thought, that's it, that's what spring's gonna be.
They weren't picked in a garden.
Roses are the blooming new print for spring, a garden of wild color. Norma Kamali interpreted the rose from head to toe in New York. And in London, Betty Jackson's roses are like an abstract watercolor. Missoni wove stems of roses in their knit dresses. And Perry Ellis brought the rose to elegant evening wear. But the print story isn't all florals.
They are not prints as traditional print. They are more design, they are more art directed.
It's just like complete hodgepodge.
Scramble prints mix print upon print to create the newest look for spring. Karl Lagerfeld created this print for Fendi with geometric pieces of paper cutouts. While Gianni Versace mixes florals with stripes for a new look. Basile teams florals with oversized checks. And even street graffiti inspired one of the hottest prints. And that's the news. Print it. What's the leg-revealing must-buy for spring?
A short. She can wear it, look.
That's right. Look at the best of these leggy shorts from the fashion capitals of the world. The must-buy from Video Fashion Monthly. Who says you don't want to be caught short?